meaning. So we just can't just disregard this. Now, will this start? Will Armageddon start? Will the first 7 years start? We don't know. We don't know the hour time. We don't know exactly what God is going to do, but this is prophecy, and it's my job, my duty to bring this to you. Because we see here, verse 2 says that the Lord is coming like a thief in the night. But look at verse 3. When they shall say peace and safety, then sudden destruction cometh upon them, as travail upon a woman with child, and they shall not escape. So we see that when they're talking peace and safety, officials and everything, look out. We see the president over here in China, and when you see them together on TV, they look so chummy. So they look like buddies. So, you know, president is saying I think he's meeting over there today as of this podcast, you know, and he's, you know, don't worry, you know, the missiles, don't worry about them. And you know, they're going to try to get him to get rid of them and so forth. But as of now, you have no worry. We're peaceful with China. And then you look at again, I spoke about the wall and things like that. You look at, there's opposition there, yes, but he's saying with the president there, everything's good. I mean, the president is all over the world, and he's claiming peace here, peace there. And he's really on the go. He's really saying peace here and peace there. He's signing off on so many things. So we need to keep our eyes open. And when this is signed, keep your eyes open. What does it mean? Is this prophecy here really true? Peace. Is this the beginnings of Armageddon? The beginnings of the 7 years? So we have to be, we just have to just not be asleep. And then again, let me read down here. It says, but verse 4, but ye brethren are not in darkness, that the day should overtake you as a thief. So this means here, we're not totally in the dark, that the day gonna take us over as a thief. Because all of these things are happening right here. Peace. We're not in the dark. See, so that's why we have to know these things. And I'm not saying, you know, the churches, I'm not saying open the doors and bring this official in and this one in, vote for me and vote for me as president here in the upcoming. I'm not saying bring those people in to campaign. But I am saying, you know, we are to let the people know what's being said. And I can tell you, I don't know if this will start the 7 years. I don't know, but I am going to keep my eyes open. I'm going to keep my ears open, and I am going to let you know the things that are going on and what I'm seeing here, so that you won't be in the dark. You know, so again, we are children of the light. We're children of the day. We're not of the night, not of the darkness. And that's just complimenting verse 4. That we are not in the darkness, that day should overtake us as a thief. It says, verse 6, but let us not sleep as do others, but let us watch and be sober. For that they that sleep in the night and they that be drunken are drunken in the night. We want to be sober. We don't want to be drunk. We want to know what's going on around the world, what's going on in Israel and Jerusalem, what's going on. And then it says, but let us who are of the day be sober, putting on the breastplate of faith and love, and for an helmet the hope of salvation. For God have not appointed us to wrath, but to obtain salvation by our Lord Jesus Christ, who died for us, that whether we wake or sleep, we should live together with him. That's beautiful. Whether we wake or sleep. If you go to sleep right here, right now, you know, you just temporarily sleep. You know, because you live. When Jesus came here, now we have peace, prosperity, deliverance, healing, health, eternal life, everything. So, none of this stands anymore. He died for us. So in verse 11 says, wherefore comfort yourselves together and edify one another, even as also ye do. I'm getting so excited, ladies and gentlemen. We are living in a wonderful, wonderful time. We ought to edify each other. We ought to pull each other together. We ought to let each other know what's going on. And what are your thoughts? What do you think? Let me know. If you got any questions or comments. And I'm just here. We comfort each other. And we just let each other know, hey, everything is all right. That, hey, everything, we are in wonderful, wonderful hands of the Lord. We don't have to be scared. We don't have to, when these things are happening, hold your head up. Let's comfort each other. Let's let other people know as well. And let's bring people into the kingdom. And right now, Romans chapter 10, verse 9 through 10. If you say it with your mouth, say it out loud, and believe in your heart that Jesus is Lord, you shall be saved. And right now, if you'd like to dedicate or rededicate yourself, there's no cookie cutter thing to say, but you can repeat after me right now and say, Lord Jesus, I believe that you are the Son of God and that you died on the cross for my sins. Lord Jesus, I ask that you come into my life as my Lord and as my Savior, and I will serve you for the rest of my life. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Amen, amen, amen. Congratulations, brothers and sisters, if you said that for the first time. There's much joy in the heavens. Congratulations. If you don't already, find your place of worship somewhere where you can know and you can grow. Hallelujah. Feel the blessings of the Lord. Find you that place of worship. If you don't already, God will lead you. God will guide your paths. Again, you all know that I love Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5 through 6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not on to your own understanding. And everything you do, acknowledge him. Acknowledge him. He is first. And he shall direct your path. So you have nothing to worry about. And stay prayed up. Pray, pray, pray. Stay as close to God. Get that close relationship. Ask God in prayer what's going on right now. Ask God in prayer, is this true? Ask God, this just may be a revelation for you. Ask God. And also read your Bibles. Read, read, read. I encourage you all the time because there's power in those scriptures. See, we don't want to be asleep. We don't want to be asleep. We want to stay woke. We want to stay sober. We want to know what's going on in the news and what's everything. We want to know about the Antichrist, what's going on. They say he's coming within the 3.5 years of the 7 years and saying I'm God and going to sit on his throne or whatever and all of that. Whatever throne it is, I don't know. Maybe going over there in Israel. I've even heard that. I don't know. Sitting over there in the temple saying that he's God. I don't know. But see, we have to see. We have to see. There's supposed to be the Antichrist released 3.5 years of the 7 saying they're God. So I know some pastors, pastor out here right now that's saying he's God. I don't know. But see, that's why we just have to stay abreast of what's going on. We know right from wrong, you know, and pray for each other. Pray for each other and encourage each other. So I just brought this out to you, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters. Take it and check these links out and just keep your eyes and ears open on much more and things to come. And just spread the word. Spread the word. Share this show. I love you all, my brothers and sisters. I bought you this on a Monday. Again, stay tuned. Every Tuesday, every Thursday. And we are going to end now in prayer. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you, Father God, I thank you, Father God, for using me as a vessel, letting your Holy Spirit flow through me, Father God, letting your Holy Spirit flow through me so that I can bring out these words and keep, Father God, your sons and your daughters alert on what's going on around the world. And just as we don't want to be asleep, we don't want to be asleep, Father God. We want to stay sober. I'm here just to do your will, Father God, to let the people know what's going on out here, that we need to just stay abreast of what's going on. And Father God, I thank you. I thank you, Father God, for everything. I thank you for your words. I thank you, Father, for giving us discernment to know the truth, to know, Father God. I pray that you, the people are lifted here, Father God, to hear your words, to hear your voice, to hear your message. I pray, Father God, that they're open and they are ready and they have received this message, and we'll go forward and we'll stay alert, Father God. I thank you, I thank you, I thank you for this time that we are here. And I thank you for the return of Jesus. And one thing we know, Father God, Jesus will return soon. We may not know, we don't know the day and the hour and the minute and the second, but we are not in the dark. And I thank you, Father, for these things happening. And I pray for all our officials. And I pray for all my brothers and sisters right here on the line. And I pray that everyone spreads this message. And I thank you, Father God, and I love you. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray. Thank you, brothers and sisters. Thank you, brothers and sisters. I pray. Amen, amen. Thank you for tuning in. And until next time, peace, and I love you all.